The twin bombings in Kabul shocked the entire world. But what was most shocking was that 9 journalists were killed. We are here with the ambassador of Afghanistan, Dr. S.M. Abdali, and he is here to talk about the incident. Dr. Abdali, can you please tell us about what are the intentions behind these targeted attacks on journalists, and have they been successful? Have the terrorist groups that have led to that have conducted these attacks, have they been successful in their endeavor?
Well, you see, if their endeavor was to silence the media, they will not succeed, I'm sure, because the media will continue to do its great job to be neutral, to reflect the ground realities in Afghanistan and elsewhere. But the attack which took place obviously is clear, which is to scare the media. The media is, I think, one of the best tools, rather the best tool to deal with terrorism in terms of their activities, in terms of exposing what they've been doing in Afghanistan and elsewhere in the region. So we hope that the media globally and regionally all will join hands to stop, and use their best means to put pressure on those who are not allowing the media to be free and reflect the ground realities.
And since the attack has taken place, what are the kind of safety provisions that your government has allowed so that journalists can be in a positive work atmosphere in a war zone like?
Well, we have measures. Security. Media is an independent entity, and Afghanistan after the attack recently had a joint meeting with the media, and we have offered our support, and we'll be doing anything we can to provide the media protection if they seek to have protection from the Afghan government.
In a very recent interview, you said that after Afghanistan, India is the second country which in South Asia which faces the same threats of extremism and terrorism. So what are the threats that you speak of, and what should the two countries be doing?
Threats are clear, especially the threat of terrorism. Afghanistan and India are facing the same common problem, which is terrorism, and we hope that India and Afghanistan, together with the rest of the region, will join hands to fight terrorism, which is affecting everyone. So Afghanistan is hopeful, and of course our relationship has been great. India and Afghanistan are doing much in this regard, and we only expect our other neighbors and the global community to join us to work for a common fight, which is sincere, based on the principles that we all seek.
What lies next in the India-Afghanistan relationships?
Well, our intentions are to grow this relationship further, and we have been successful in the last many years to make this relationship to a much higher level. Afghanistan-India relationship in the recent past has been a unique relationship, and of course Afghanistan-India are doing a lot in economic, in the security, in the culture, in all these fields, education, and our future, of course, goals are to make it as strong as possible, and we're very hopeful that this relationship will be built on in a manner that other countries will also join us in such a friendly environment to work for a common cause.
Could you also talk about the kind of issues that Pakistan must be dealing with China and India coming together in Afghanistan right now?
We are very happy that China and India together join hands, and they have offered at least to work together in Afghanistan. That's exactly what we've been asking from all of our neighbors, that peace in Afghanistan is a prerequisite to peace and stability in the whole region. And we hope on that note that region all together, including China and India, will come together to invest in Afghanistan and work for each other's interests.
Afghanistan, for the first time, will be playing a test match with India. So it's a very historic moment for Afghanistan right now. What do you have to say about that?
I'm very happy that the first test match is going to be played between India and Afghanistan. This is a dream, and this was a dream for our cricket team. And I'm glad that our team is going to play against India, a country that has done so great globally in cricket field, and Afghanistan not only in the test match, but has done so much in the IPL for players right now playing in the IPL franchises. The two players are the backbone of the two teams, so we're glad to see our teams playing so well, and we hope that the cricket ties will go to a much higher level so that the people-to-people contact is much more grown and strengthened.
All right, thank you so much.